Evo, stigli smo do...
Finala.
Do finala ovog natjecanja. Ovo je ovaj materijal koji ste vidjeli večeras. To je materijal koji smo skupili u zadnjih 14 dana. So, the material you have seen was created by six artists I mentioned before. In these 14 days of research and living in the city, before I can say something more, I would like you to ask us about the things you've seen, the things you felt, you liked, you didn't like, you disliked, and also maybe things you didn't understand.
Since we asked you already several questions, it's only fair that you ask us something. I'm sure there's one question at least that might be on your mind that you have to ask. We're going to go in October to make a preliminary research, and perhaps after that, this question will be more clear. But
yeah, I think this question also raises other questions about other cities and how it quite small operation with Belgrade and the distances you have to travel. And distance is something which is also the way how you perceive the city. So, I will tell you something about what we did in the beginning. We, in order not to be just some kind of passive or objective observers of the city, we tried to create some kind of rules, some kind of games, in order to become, this brave period we were in the city, some kind of inhabitants. The six artists who created this material really lived in the city. They got different tasks to do upon which they made researches. But one of the biggest tasks was to live in the city in two different areas. And one of the group lived in New Belgrade, block 45. Probably some of you know where it is. And the second group lived in the center of the city. They lived in Francuska. And after a week, they exchanged their places. Because where we live, and it determines our view on the city, determines our distances to the places we would like to see, would like to make things. And around our house we are behaving like being almost in our private courtyard. But if we have to travel to another part of the city, we have to prepare our luggage, and it's always some kind of travel. People who live in Belgrade knows which. That every time you really have to go to another part of the city is really a journey, because this city transport is not so appropriate to this great city, and it's also very difficult. So everything has to be planned in advance to arrive.
These two apartments were not just living and sleeping places for our participants, they were also their working places. They actually worked on them. The apartments were treated in many ways in the same manner as the city itself. They were territory to be explored, territory in which they had to find their own way of navigating and their own way of orienting. Each of the places had what we call the house book. It was one fixed place where they could put all their
So in fact, these books, which Caterina will now show you, was some kind of house diaries. These two houses where the people were living. In some way, we approached the city as some kind of bank of time, as some kind of container of energies. But when I say bank of time, it means that each of us, on a certain level, invest our life and our private time by doing something and exchange this value with somebody else. And the people who are running beside you, in a few minutes you will realize in how many different directions people are running, trying to find destiny in completely different directions. We also approach the city as a kind of traveling through time, because each time you walk to the city, you are seeing different houses from different eras, different houses.
Sign language.
Okay, I'm impressed by it. Spina is also one of the six.